Hi. In computer science, the smallest unit of information is a bit. It can have two values, one or zero, which correspond, for instance, to on or off, or true or false. Here we represent a bit by a box, which can contain a one or a zero. So with one box, we can make two combinations. By combining boxes, we can make more combinations. For example, there are four possible combinations when we use two boxes. The more boxes you use, the more combinations you can make. You can ask how many combinations can be made with three boxes, or four, or more general, x boxes. Each box can contain two values, so with three boxes you can make 2 to the power 3 equals 8 combinations. In general, if we have x boxes, we can make 2 to the power x combinations, so the number of combinations is given by an exponential function. Now suppose you want to make 1,000 combinations. How many boxes do you need? In this case, you need to solve the equation 2 to the power x is equal to 1,000. Just by trying, you find that 2 to the power 9 is smaller than 1,000 and 2 to the power 10 is larger than 1,000. This means that the number x that you are looking for is between 9 and 10, and therefore you need 10 boxes to make at least 1,000 combinations. But what if you want to make at least 10 billion combinations? You really don't want to calculate successive powers of 2 until you pass 10 billion. So we want to solve the equation 2 to the power x is equal to 10 billion. And to do this, we need the inverse of the exponential function 2 to the power x. This inverse is called a logarithm. Let's consider a more general setting. We look at the exponential function with base b larger than 1, so f of x is b to the power x. The function b to the power x is defined for any x, so the domain of f is the whole real line. The range of this function consists of all positive numbers. If we look at the graph of b to the power x, we see that it satisfies the horizontal line test, that is, the graph intersects a horizontal line in at most one point. So from the previous video, we know that f has an inverse function. This inverse is called the logarithm in base b. From what we know from inverse functions, we have the following properties. Log base b is the inverse of b to the power x, so y is equal to log base b of x precisely when b to the power y is equal to x. The domain of log base b is the range of b to the power x and the other way around. For example, log base 2 of 8 is equal to 3 because 2 to the power 3 equals 8. A logarithm can also be negative. For instance, log base 5 of 1 over 5 is equal to minus 1 because 5 to the power minus 1 equals 1 over 5. In general, log base b of b to the power a equals a. Also, note that log base b of 1 equals 0 for any base b, since b to the power 0 is always equal to 1. Although logarithms can be defined for any base b greater than 1, the numbers 10 and e are the most common bases. If the base of the logarithm is the number e, we call it the natural logarithm, and we use the notation ln of x. The logarithm in base 2 is also frequently used, especially in computer science, as you saw in the beginning of this video. If the symbol log is used without a base, the base should be clear from the context. Most often, this means the base is equal to 10. Let's go back to the general function log base b of x. Since this is the inverse of the exponential function b to the power x, the graph of log base b of x is the reflection of the graph of b to the power x in the line y equals x. Note that the logarithm tends to minus infinity if x tends to 0. Recall that the exponential function b to the power x grows faster than x to the power c for any positive number c. As a consequence, the inverse of b to the power x grows slower than the inverse of x to the power c, which is x to the power 1 over c. Since d is 1 over c is also positive for any positive number c, we find that log base b of x grows slower than x to the power d for any positive number d. If we compare, for example, the graphs of log base 2x and x to the power 1 over 3, it seems that for x larger than 3, the graph of x to the power 1 over 3 lies below the graph of log base 2 of x. But if we zoom out, we see that x to the power 1 over 3 catches up at some point, and from there it grows much faster. Let's summarize what we know so far about logarithm. First, the logarithm in base b is the inverse of the exponential function b to the power x. And second, a logarithm grows slower than x to the power d for any positive number d. Okay, let's go back to the question from the beginning. How can we solve 2 to the power x is equal to 10 billion? Using a logarithm, we find that x equals log base 2 of 10 billion. But how big is this number? If you want to use a simple calculator to find out, you need rules of calculations for logarithms. We look at these rules in the next video.